Hey there, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm thrilled to guide you through the process of creating native Android and iOS widgets and seamlessly sending data to them using a Flutter app. But before we dive in, make sure to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon to stay updated with our latest content. Let's get started on this exciting journey. To begin, let's start by building an iOS widget. The first step is to install the Home Widget package in your Flutter project. Next, open your command terminal and enter the following command: Flutter build iOS, config only, to generate pods in the project. Now, right-click on the iOS folder and open it in Xcode. Once opened, click on Runner and then on the plus icon in the bottom bar. Search for Widget Extensions and click Next. Give the name Home Widget to the extension. Uncheck the Live Activity and App Intent and click on Finish. Activate the extension. Now, go to the Build Phase tab in Runner and drag the thin binary to the bottom. Then, embed Pod Frameworks below it. Proceed to the Signing and Capabilities tab of the widget extension and click on the Plus Capability button. Search for App Groups and click on it. Create a new app group. Let's name it group.homewidget. Do the same in the Signing and Capabilities tab of Runner and add the same app group to it. Go to the App Widget Swift file and remove the preview code. Now, let's go to the main.dart file in the lib folder. I'll use the increment function provided in the demo Flutter application. Go to the function. First, create an init method to set the app group ID using homewidget.setAppGroupID. Create a string named appGroupID and assign it the same value you added in the runner and widget app groups. To update values in the widgets, utilize the homewidget.updateWidget method, specifying the iOS widget name you assigned, and do the same for Android. Create two strings for this purpose. Now, create a title string in the increment function with the counter and utilize homewidget.saveWidgetData to save the title with the key headline title. Also, use homewidget.updateWidget method to update the widget. Navigate to the widget file and within the simple entry struct, add a title string data type, replacing the emoji with the title variable throughout the file. In the getSnapshot method, utilize user defaults to retrieve the title using the app group and the key headline near title, and set the title in the entry. Finally, ensure that the minimum deployment version of your iOS in the General tab of the Widget section is less than the simulator you are using. In the Build Phases tab of the Runner, drag the Embed Frameworks below Embed Foundation Extension. Now navigate back to the widget file, and within the Timeline function, utilize the GetSnapshot method to retrieve the timeline for the entry. Run the app and click on the plus button at the bottom to increase the counter. Then, navigate to the home screen, where you'll observe that the counter is dynamically changing in the title of the widget as well. The iOS widget is working well. Now let's move on to the Android widget. Go back to VS Code and open the Android folder in Android Studio. Right-click on the app, then select New and choose Widget. If you don't see this option, navigate to the SDK Tools and ensure that all components except NDK are installed. After installation, reopen the folder in Android Studio. The option should now be available. Add the class name, Home Widget, in the widget extension, then click Finish. As you can see, we are getting a Kotlin error. To resolve this Kotlin error, navigate to the build.gradle file and delete the automatically generated build script in it. Then rebuild the project in Android Studio to see if the error disappears. To enable data sharing with Android, you need to install the Shared Preferences package. Once you've installed the Shared Preferences package, return to Android Studio and import the HomeWidget plugin. Then, create a variable named WidgetData to retrieve data from the HomeWidget using HomeWidget plugin. Get data within the OnUpdate method. Utilize remote views to construct a view, retrieving the string from WidgetData using WidgetData.getString and the key headline title. Finally, set the text view text with the ID headline title to the title. In the HomeWidget.xml file within the Res Layout folder, ensure that the ID of the text view is set to headline title. Then, return to the HomeWidget file and replace your widget name with the actual name of your widget. Also, replace the update app widget method by calling app widget manager update app widget and passing the app widget ID and views as arguments. Now rerun the app and increment the counter to 2. Then navigate back to the home page and add the widget. You'll notice that the counter dynamically updates in the title of the widget. In Android, clicking the widget doesn't automatically open the app like it does in iOS. To achieve this functionality, we need to use pending intent. You can set the on-click pending intent for the widget view and specify the activity you want to open when clicked. And that's all for today. Thanks for watching. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Stay tuned for more exciting Flutter development content. Happy coding!